Hi, I'm Mathieu Stern, and today we are going to see how to use an enlarger lens on your mirrorless camera. Before the digital ages, enlargers were used to enlarge and reproduce photos by using negative. With an enlarger, the image of the negative is projected on photographic paper through a lens connected to a bellows to focus. Nowadays, it's really easy and cheap to find just the lens of the enlarger. But because it was not made to focus on its own, you need to find a way to connect it to your camera and focus. For this tutorial, we will use an old Russian enlarger lens, the Vega 22. A really weird lens with internal color filters. The Vega 22 comes with an M42 mount. Many enlarger lenses come with an M42 mount, but you can't connect it directly to an M42 adapter and then to your camera because you can't focus. There is no focus mechanism. So you need to connect the lens to an helicoidal M42 ring and this ring to the M42 to your camera adapter. And now you can focus. Because these lenses were made to have a perfect reproduction of images, they are really sharp. As you can see, your image will be really, really sharp, but it has absolutely no depth of field. It will be good for landscapes or for paparazzi shots or for details, but it will not be good for portraits or for depth of field effects. This kind of lens can have internal color filters that you can use to make experiments on coloring your images or making different kind of black and white. If you add an extension tube, you can also do interesting macro and really sharp macro. So what are the pros and cons to use an enlarger lens on your mirrorless camera? The first one is the sharpness of the image. It was made to be sharp, so you will not be disappointed. It's cheap, easy to find, and if you are not really sure with it, it's not a big problem if you spend like €5 to buy one. Most of the time, small or lightweight, and they look cool. First one, for the cons, it's hard to mount. Sometimes you will need a lot of trying and experimenting to find the good focus distance. Another con is it's not a fast lens. So you will not find a larger lens opening more than 4 or 5. You will not use it for portraits or to have a shallow depth of field. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get more weird lenses reviews, tutorials, and weird experiments. And support me on Patreon to do more weird lenses reviews and weird photo experiments. Thank you.